In terms of monetization, we believe that anything that attracts a lot of users that's fundamental to their everyday life routine is monetizable. Either you'll be able to monetize that user directly, or you'll have so many users and so much volume that you'll attract advertisers that want to get in front of those consumers. And so generally, if you're working on an important problem that matters to people, that they're in a solution that they're going to end up using every day, we think that there is generally a way to monetize there. And there's also sometimes value in waiting and not letting the monetization get in too early. It was really interesting for me, again, in the very early days of Google, we didn't have ads on site. And literally almost every email you would get every day would end in, P.S., please don't ever put ads on your site. And people were so worried about the pop-ups of 1999 and all the different animated banners. But what was really interesting is we basically said, okay, well, we need to listen to our users. Our users are saying, don't put ads on the site, but clearly we need to make money. But having that constraint and having that user feedback made us think harder about it. How could we have ads that really complemented the search experience? So that made us think about, well, could we have text ads that looked and complemented the search results in terms of their overall appearance? Could they be as relevant? Could we actually apply an auction model and quality control that made sure that those ads were as good as the results they sat next to? And it's interesting, we now have done studies where some of our users get ads and some of our users don't. And we actually see greater user happiness when they get ads. So we actually know that our advertising product makes Google search better, and that's really our goal on all of our products. But that said, there is sometimes a benefit to having the product go out, have some lead time, see how users use it, what do they think is important in the experience, so that way when you go to monetize it, it's not disruptive. Similarly, on Picasa, we let people upload photos and it's free, and a lot of people said, hey, I have way more photos than this. Like, you need to let me buy storage. You know, we want to buy storage. And so, again, like responding to that user feedback, we weren't sure. Should we put ads alongside the albums? What should we do? And there are those fears that the demand is there for storage and the direct payment, right?